Microsoft's newest Surface tablet seems to be a big hit. There were reports of lines at Microsoft stores, but there could be maybe more than meets the eye here. Let's bring in Brent Thill, Managing Director at UBS, and John Fort. Brent, is this a case of demand absolutely outstripping supply because they really just had an amazing response, or is it they just didn't make enough?
I think probably it's early, right? There's probably not that many. We saw this with the first version where they sold out on their website. So we think it's early days for Microsoft. You know, Apple's going to ship over 80 million iPads this year, and we believe in the first quarter Microsoft only shipped 500,000. So it's comparing two different stories. We think it's early. We think there are a lot of reasons to be excited about Surface. If you're an enterprise worker, you look at the full productivity suite. You look at the halo effect that Microsoft can have. Enterprise managers always already support a Microsoft environment. But there's a lot of challenges, and we're not hiding those, right?
Right.
The price point and the usability, I think, is still an issue with the content that's available.
Right. I mean, John Ford, Microsoft was kind of slow out of the gate in this space, right? Is this going to be the device that makes them catch up? What do people say?
Doubtful. Three things. First, the original Surface RT came out at $500. Doesn't seem to have blown the door off. This is $900 to $1,000, and it's selling in February. This isn't even the holiday season, so it would be surprising to see, you know, really great sales of that device, of the Surface Pro, even though this does run legacy Windows apps. You know what else runs legacy Windows apps? PCs. They're not selling that great right now either, certainly at the $900, $1,000 price point. That's why Intel is working so hard to get touchscreens down to that $600 range where they know demand will take off. So it would just run counter to all the trends for this to really be doing that well. But we'll see when they show us some numbers.
John, do you think the 128 gig iPad is going to take a bite out of this Surface interest? Basically a MacBook Air now, right? I mean, there's no difference.
Yeah.
You just slap on a $75 keyboard, you're back to a MacBook Air.
I think that's really at kind of the high-end enthusiast geek category and the enterprise user who's running Autodesk or, you know, Hollywood movies and needs lots and lots of storage, not the mainstream price point. So is that going to blow the doors off the Surface? Well, I don't know, but neither one of those is probably going to do very large volume.
We've got a year-to-date chart up there, which really tells the story. Look at that, Brian. Apple in the green. Actually, year-to-date is down. Microsoft is actually holding up pretty well. And I see, Brent, we can't discuss this. We've run out of time. But I see you've got a rating of buy and a target price of $28 there for Microsoft. There you go. Year-to-date, 4% to the upside. Apple down.
You know what they're saying in Redmond. Everything's fine.
Everything's fine.